Hi everyone, I'm Nicole van der Hoeven, and a few weeks ago, I did an overview on all Grafana Labs projects, thinking about how I can use them for my performance testing. Today, I'm actually going to start putting that into good use. I already have a Kubernetes cluster that's being managed by DigitalOcean, and what I want to do is install Prometheus and Grafana into my cluster and be able to visualize the metrics from Prometheus about my cluster on Grafana. So here's how I'm going to do that. Okay, so here is my DigitalOcean cluster. It is made up of three nodes, and they're going to host an application called Poke API. There are a few ways to install Grafana and Prometheus into a cluster, and I'm just choosing the easiest way for me, which is doing it through Helm. So Helm is like, if you don't know, it's a package manager for Kubernetes. So if you don't already have that, you'll need to install Helm first before you follow along. Okay, so this is the Prometheus community Helm chart, and I'm just going to copy this and go over to my terminal here and add this repository, right? It's been added. And now I'm actually going to install Prometheus. Right, there we are. The Prometheus push gateway can be accessed by 9091. Okay, looks like we've got Prometheus up and running. The cool thing about this is that Prometheus just works natively with Kubernetes. So it's already tracking metrics to do with the Kubernetes cluster. Now I'm going to add this Grafana Helm chart as a repository. It's the same thing. I'm just going to copy this and paste it into my terminal. And then I'm just going to install Grafana. Grafana. Three times Grafana there. But okay. Now we should be able to log in. Before we do that, though, we'll want to forward the port that Grafana is running on so that we can access the Grafana UI from the local machine. So to do that, I'm going to get services. And yep, see, just verifying that Grafana and Prometheus are both already running. Now I'm going to go into the Grafana pod to see which port it's running on so that I know which port to forward. And then kubectl logs Grafana. Okay, looks like it's using port 3000, which is the default. So now I can forward the Grafana port. Now if we go into a browser here, we should be able to go to localhost 3000. And yep, okay, we're accessing the Grafana UI on my cluster. So I know from the logs in the pod earlier that the username is going to be admin, but I don't know what the password is. And there's no default password when you install it this way. So I'm just going to go find that using this code here. I'm copying that entire string and pasting it into Grafana. Okay. Looks like I'm in. Prometheus does come with a UI as well. I probably won't be using it as much once I've got it set up with Grafana, but I'm just going to forward it anyway just to make sure that it's there and that it's all working. So same process for Prometheus. I'm going to port forward it, except this time Prometheus is on port 9090. Okay, it's forwarding, so let's head to localhost 9090. And there it is. Now I've got Prometheus set up as well as Grafana, but Prometheus isn't really talking to Grafana yet, so I need to make sure that Grafana knows what I want to be visualizing. First, I want to add Prometheus as a data source. Select Prometheus there, and in the URL, I'm going to use Prometheus server, and I'm going to click Save and Test. I'm going to import a dashboard. Now you can create your own dashboard, and that's probably what I'm going to do later on once I know what metrics are important to me. But for now, I just think it's an easy way to set up to import a dashboard that already exists. And then I'll select that data source that I just created for Prometheus and I'll click import. Okay, so this is really awesome because I'm seeing all of my nodes here so I can view them separately. I can choose the namespace that I want to view, but all the metrics are just coming in and the dashboard is set up and I haven't actually done anything yet. So now I have both Prometheus and Grafana running on my cluster, and Grafana is able to access the metrics from Prometheus. That's all really good, but I want to see whether I can run a load test against my application and then see the metrics on Grafana change in response to that test. So I've got a K6 script written in JavaScript. It's called Poke API. This is what the script looks like. I only have one scenario enabled right now, and that's Poke API. Later on, I will be enabling this chaos experiment, but for now, I just wanted to be running a load test against my cluster. And it will run it'll gradually ramp up for 15 minutes up to 40 users, and then it'll stay at that level for an extra 45 minutes. And the actual function here gets a random Pokemon from the CSV file and passes that Pokemon in a request to the application. Then it checks to make sure that the name of the Pokemon selected is returned in the response, indicating a valid response. We're also checking for an HTTP 200. I'm going to fire it off here. Okay, looks like it's running, but let's see what it looks like on Grafana. Well, right off the bat, we see a change in network IO signifying that there is data being sent back and forth. And I'm already spotting that the CPU usage is getting quite high, even on this initial test. It's already heading up to about 70% utilization. Okay, so I've stopped the test, and these are the metrics that K6 gives me at the end of the test. The problem is that these are like end of test summary metrics, so they're aggregated, and I'm not really seeing the response times in real time. An easy way to get around this is by using K6 Cloud, either by piping the results out from the local machine to K6 Cloud, or by just running the test from K6 Cloud in the first place. It isn't possible to run chaos experiments on K6 Cloud right now, but what I can do is I can run this test locally and then just output the data to the cloud. That's starting up, and I'm going to click this. It opened up in my other monitor here, and this is what that looks like because I'm already logged into the K6 Cloud account that I'm using. So this is really nice because we can see the response times and the requests in real time. So it's really easy to monitor the test side of things. And scrolling down here, we can also see the HTTP responses. We see that we've got mostly 301s and 200s, which is fine, but we did get 9 404s. And we can click into that to see the distribution. Now for this test, I do expect some errors because not all of the Pokemon that I'm querying exist in the database. So this sort of distribution is fine. What I don't want is something that just increases as time goes on or large spikes of errors. And that will certainly give me a lot more information and nice charts to look at about the results of the test. But I'm already looking at Grafana for the metrics regarding my cluster and my application there. So what would be really cool is if I could get the K6 metrics also in Grafana. And that's going to be what I'm doing for the next time. I hope this was useful and see you next time.